Christmas is just around the corner, and you might be thinking to yourself, I still don't have anything for all my loved ones. What am I going to put under the tree? Well, how about your very own calendar? In this video, we're going to cover how to create and make a calendar using Zoner Photo Studio X, and most importantly, how to order it. There's also going to be a link in the description below that's going to cover some topics and some inspiration of what sort of photos you can use to create such a calendar. One such example, maybe with your friends or with your kids. Let's go take a look. Okay, so we already have Zoner Photo Studio X open and we're in the print module. Here, just choose calendar and then click on create a new project. Right up here, you can choose the format of the calendar that you want. You're gonna have a choice of various sizes, whether that's vertical or horizontal, and also whether you want it to be a 1 month or 2 month layout. We also have an A3 high definition option, which is gonna be also 11.5 by 16.5 inches. And you can select that for weekly or bi-weekly options. Or you can just choose your own dimensions and do it however you like. Now for demonstration purposes, let's choose the A4 and 1 month option in the landscape orientation. Now as a first step, I'm gonna insert the photos I want to have in each month directly into the calendar. And this is done so that when selecting a project template, I can already see how it will look. Now I'm gonna drag them into the calendar straight from the film strip. Now, of course, the choice of photos is gonna be yours. One idea and something that I use is from the year prior, I'll take photos that I actually took within the same month and then stick them into that exact same month. But you can just create a collection of whatever you want. It's up to you. Now we can also place multiple photographs on a single page. And so here you choose how many photos per page you want and in what particular layout. You can also choose your photo placement mode, which in other words means whether you want your photos to fill, fit, or fit to square. And then you can also choose the layout style, which means that you can give your photographs certain frames and then you can customize them as you like. Now, if you're more interested in the specific nuances of the layout settings, we've already done a video on this where we go into a lot more detail on how to create a photo book, and you'll find a link in the description below. Personally, I like it when the photo in the calendar is as visible as possible. So I'm gonna choose only one, and I'm gonna have it span the entire page without any borders whatsoever. Now, once we've got our photos inserted, let's choose the project template. Here you have a choice of several variants. You can see that each template variant either has a filled area for calendar days or a transparent one, which allows the photo to be visible beneath the calendar part. Now I'm gonna choose this template here where there's enough space for, say, listed holidays, and I want it to be transparent so that I can actually see the entire photo. Notice that if I had two photos side by side here, then this template would almost completely cover one single photograph. So this is why I actually inserted photographs into the template first, so I could adjust the template to the photographs afterwards and not the other way around. Right below the template, you can adjust the background opacity, background color, as well as font color. And I'm gonna keep the background black because white wouldn't look good on some of the photos I have in this particular example. I'm also gonna keep the font color white and just change the font style. Now let's take a look at the calendar settings. The first is gonna be general, where you choose the year for the calendar, starting with your month, language, and also the starting day of the week. I'm gonna stick with the default settings. Next are gonna be your years. Here you set the parameters for the year that is on the main page of the calendar, and I'm gonna increase the font size, keep the color white, and keep it bold. Okay, let's move on to the next section, which is gonna be our months. Here again, you can change the font size as well as color of the months, and additionally choose whether you want them in uppercase or lowercase. The last part is gonna be our days. And here the parameters are even more divided into show day names, highlight special days, and show name days. You can disable these parts individually by clicking on the checkbox next to each item. And as with the previous sections, you can change the text size, font color, and style here as well. Okay, let's increase the size of days and digits font size, and also enable uppercase for the day names. If you want to change the font size for name days, be mindful of the layout so that the text doesn't actually escape the line. Well, and I'm done. Actually, wait, I'm not done. I forgot the most important part, which is the name of my calendar. On the main page is a field for inserting text. There, we're gonna write the name of our calendar. Notice that the calendar name has a separate section with adjustments. I'm gonna choose the same font as I have with the rest of the calendar just to make it nice and consistent and only increase its size. And if you don't want the name to be in this lower frame, you can move it anywhere on the photo by clicking the move frame and then just dragging it anywhere you want. But I'm gonna leave it right in the frame, right here. Now that we have the actual calendar ready, we can move on to the order. In the top right panel, I'm gonna click on add to cart, and I'm gonna click on show cart or just click directly on the cart in the top bar, and then we're gonna order. Now let's just go to the browser to complete the order. Here you can enter any discount code you might have, fill in the invoice details, choose the delivery and payment method, and then just confirm the order. So by now you know how to create a beautiful calendar in Zoner Photo Studio X, and you might be able to surprise them under the tree this year. I hope that's informative for you guys. That's it from me. Hit the subscribe bell so that you never miss another video we put out. Give us a like and let us know what you think below, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Ciao.